Hello, I'm Kasasagi Usagi, and I'm here with more NieR Replicant. Here, I'm working my way through the DLC to various successful degrees. I wanted to get further along, like I was about where I was before we beefed it yesterday. But I was trying to rush and I just made more mistakes. It's doing a little better. I definitely kill things fast. That's good. Are you dead? But it's still pretty fucking rough.
Seems we have been shut in.
Oh, the places you'll go. Out the ones that are just shooting regular ass red balls. One horrible menace at a time.
Yeah.
robots. I remember how I dealt with this, and it was with a lot of cheese. It is very good. Oh, that's right. Thank you. There you go. I have all the spells. I just don't use them all. Like, at all. I don't have any sticks. Alright, so this is where we were yesterday, and things were not ideal. Keep it in mind for next time. If hopefully there won't be it. Yeah. That was blue. Super confident that I didn't even kill one of these guys last time. Well, I still think it's gonna take a while. It shouldn't be too bad. Don't touch me. Why I don't use dark hand. Yeah, no, that's not gonna work for me. I understand what it can do. I cannot, it's just, that is not gonna fly.
Just go.
hearing them die. It's great. I just have to get too close. There's too many of them. I think maybe the slappies and then the dark execution with the punchies is probably pretty good. Did get this far. This is gonna take some doing.
Thank you.
without the execution. Definitely not be dead when you return. Definitely won't be dead. God, if I could just kill one of these. Life would be so good. Yeah, we got here yesterday, and I couldn't do it. And I'm much stronger than I was yesterday, just considering how fast everything else has gone down. But these guys just won't. And I have been like hitting them with the fists. It just doesn't seem to matter. Another. No, it doesn't. The puppet priest collects the accursed prayers and polishes the vessel. Oh no, I know what this is, and I want no part of it. Be sick. Oh no. Not like this. Yoko Taro! I have a thought, but I'm afraid to voice it and make it come true. But because things don't really attack you, can you imagine, like, missing one is a game over and you have to do everything all over again? Don't do it. Don't do it, Piggy. Don't do it! I'm so afraid of that pig. Piggies are friends. Sounds right, sprightly. I don't like any of it though. I don't like it. That made me so dizzy. Oh, Yoko Taro. Okay. No problem. What I'm gonna do before I hit this door is that I did not get myself a sippy beforehand. So I'm gonna go grab that. And then we're gonna continue to moose. I also wonder what fresh hell awaits me. And I know it's hell. I know there's crafting materials back here. I should actually... I should do me a favor. And I should leave. And I should go replenish my health supplies. And then I should go tackle that door.
Something wrong?
I feel as if I'm...
I know what you...
Okay. Give me your seeds. I should have enough tomorrow. Well, no. In a few days from now.
It up. Shop here more often.
I don't care. Okay, let's go. And if I die, I die, and we'll just move along. I would like to get it done so I can grind out those materials. But, whoa, this isn't my house.
Yeah. Lately, I haven't been able to stop thinking about it.
The world of the...
Yes. While I was up, I also grabbed some chips and salsa. And it is very, very spicy. And very, very crunchy. But it's very delicious. Okay. God, I'm afraid for my all my beans. So long as the memory exists, so long as mankind has hope, a bloody battle will be waged over the holy domain of the body. One of them. And it only took me a bunch of healing items to do so. I think this is bullshit. Thank you. Oh, are you fucking kidding me? I'm not really familiar with those. That's not helpful at first. That's a good question. Love the answer to that, not doing it any damage. Thank you. Well, I need to be at full health, or I will die! Probably, yeah. Oh no! foolish vessel. Oh no! I tried my darndest, but
something wrong?
Yeah, I'm just gonna have to be stronger. That'll probably have to be a different ending run for door 3.
Because
like the sword made 2 a lot easier, but it was still really hard. So I think a few more levels in the pocket will probably sort that all out. So, we're 1 hour and 11. I know, it's gonna be very exciting, but let me do some fishing, because I only have one catfish. Let me do fishing, and then we'll get that squared away, and then I know where the last two quests are, not including the flowers, but we have to do game first. I'm not gonna worry too much about upgrading stuff and not having the materials. Not until we hit until we hit closer to the last few endings. Bars. And fishing will be nice and relaxed. It'll be fine. Emil scared the shit out of me. I don't feel that I should be catching tree branches with my very expensive carp bait video game. I don't think that's right, and I don't think that's fair. I did a lot of my fishing off stream. I think this is one of the few times I'm actually fishing for everybody. It's not usually this easy. I'm just a very good fisher. It's usually like It's so long, and the bar goes so much slower. Uh-oh. Give me the fish! 8. Jesus Christ. Ghosts. I'm in no mood. I have no healing items. We will go restock. I'm gonna buy medical herbs because I usually get those in abundance.
Shop here more often.
Yeah. Gosh. The wiki said that you needed to be level 35 to do door C. As someone who was level 35, I believe that number is 45.
I decided to tell my wife a killer joke that makes her bust a gut once a day. Anyway, enough about me.
Maybe the replicant levels are just higher, which would make sense. I am tired. So sleepy.
I have your ingredients.
Right then, here's your payment. And now let me whip this up. La-da-dum.
La-da-dum.
All right, dig in. How is it?
It's delicious. I just wish I could share it with Yona.
Woo! We've got another item for the menu.
I'll definitely try to stop by again. Good luck.
We are at 88, yeah, okay. I do not think I missed any as a little lad, but I really hope I didn't. That would be devastating. It would be just so sad. I don't know why I've chosen to walk, but alright, we move on to main story stuff. Done all that I can. All that I am physically capable of doing, which turns out wasn't very much. Thank you. do like the way you think, Sprightly. But you see, the third door has all the crafting items. All the rare crafting items, allegedly. I imagine once it's easier to get through, it's probably a much better grind than a... Like, the second door is clearly a good place to farm the titanium alloys. I got 6. Like, immediately. I think that's pretty great. The bee's knees.
Learned anything new about the Shadow Lord's key, Popola?
You know, I was just going to talk to you about that. You remember the Airy, right?
That depressing shell of a village?
Not so much anymore, it sounds like. I just got this letter from the village chief. Have a look.
I definitely don't have any poison words. Like, 100%. Because I was trying to find words that, would do item drops, better item drops for me when I was farming, and so I had to go through every word. But there was no... I do not have any poison yet, but I am missing a lot of words. From the office of the Chief of the Airy to Popola. My greetings to you and your village. I hope everything is going well. Our village has shut itself away from the world for far too many years, and we have therefore decided it is time to change our ways. As part of this endeavor, we have resolved to establish a shop within the village. It is now open for business, and I look forward to seeing a great many customers visit from all over the world. With regard to the sacrifice keyword you wrote about, one of our villagers claimed to know the meaning behind the term. You are more than welcome to speak with him on the matter as part of your visit to the area. I hope to hear from you again soon.
Sacrifice? Isn't that the name of one of the key fragments?
That's right. I've been trading notes with leaders from every town in the land.
You're amazing, Popola.
This entire affair strikes me as a bit too convenient.
I'm afraid Grimoire Vice is correct.
What do you mean?
The area has been shut off from the world for years. And now they've not only opened trade routes, but they freely exchange information about the Shadow Lord.
I agree. It seems rather unnatural and dangerous.
You're overthinking it. Besides, I don't care if it's dangerous. I won't get Yona back by just sitting around and waiting. If there are shades there, I'll just kill him and be done with it.
Oh dear.
Well, if that's the way you feel, I guess I won't stop you. Try speaking with the chief when you get there.
Let's go see the chief.
What a soul-crushing place.
There is one thing, and I don't know if it gets explained later. Are those the name of monsters? Those are words. Okay. I think I have the H one. Do. But it never said. Where do you find out it has poison damage? Oh, and it's combined? Does it make something? It says nothing. Oh, okay. Oh, there it is. So you have to randomly combine them to see what hidden effects there are? That's obnoxious.
I cannot fathom that village setting up a mercantile. They must have truly opened their minds.
Oh shit. Yeah, Forlorn bracelets, let's go!
Aren't you glad to be going back home, Kaine?
Home? This is a shithole.
Don't be so nervous, Kaine. We'll protect you.
I got me taken care of. Worry about protecting yourself.
There's a guy at the other end of the bridge, and then one fighting the boar. Forlorn bracelets! Or necklaces. They're necklaces. I need necklaces! Let's go! Damn it!
It's home to so many terrible widow memories, isn't it, Kaine?
Shut up, shut up, shut up!
I do need silver ore. And I did need a dented bat, for what it was worth. Although I have quite a few of those. I'm stuck. Da-da-da.
We do not desire.
We do not desire needless conflict.
If we can continue to live with humans, then we can continue to live peacefully.
But that young man will come.
Yes, the young man will come.
He will kill us all, women and children included.
What should we do? What can we do?
Feeling. When we first came here, well, not the first time we came here, but when we did this part in Route A, I had a feeling that these shades were just trying to live as people. I had no idea there were hidden status effects. It seems sort of obnoxious to try and, like, piece them all together. Oh, is there... Oh! Last chance for egg! Oh, man. We should try. I should spend a Friday trying to finish up some of those small things in Hollow Knight. Especially before the sequel comes out.
Stay away! Get back!
What will become of this village?
No egg. Burn it all to the ground. Emil, get ready.
Shut up! Shut up! There's no point in living anymore.
If you're not ashamed, then prove it!
Yeah, that would be suffering considering how long I haven't played that game. God, it would be miserable. Lost all my barely functioning reflexes.
The shades attacked again last night.
It's over for us and for you.
I don't believe in anything anymore. I'm too scared to trust anyone.
You. I know you.
Welcome. We've got some new items in stock today.
Do you?
Come back soon, I'll...
Make sure...
Oh, fuck. I do need some of these. They definitely burned through some of the shit I had.
Come back. My weapons may not be the latest and greatest.
Liar!
Thanks.
I think I'm done with you too.
Why not? I hope you grow some real beauts.
I'd almost forgotten what the breeze felt like.
Man, I was so tired of holding up indoors.
Oh, I think I forgot to talk to the mayor. I thought I did that, and then I jumped and didn't do that. So let's go do that. Oopsie doodle. Couldn't live in a place like this without all, like, the railings and whatnot. Seems like a good way to perish at incredible heights and speeds.
Hello? We're here from Popola's village.
All over.
We came to ask about the letter you sent.
Our days are numbered. Our village is doomed.
As cheerful as ever, it seems.
You're the one who wrote the letter, right?
I don't know about any letter.
What the hell is going on here?
It may be faster for us to take our inquiries elsewhere. Let us ask around. Someone must know something.
I don't think I have to talk to all the houses again. I have gone about this as backwards, but... You're never gonna fall off nothing, Sparkly? I hope that's true.
Something about that.
So you know about the letter?
Maybe I don't. I'm not sure.
Ah, which is it, man?
And if I may ask, are you friends of Kaine?
You could say that.
Ah, I've heard the rumors. Here to hunt shades, are you?
Indeed. Our aim is to defeat every last one.
Every last one? Everyone.
Vice! Beware! This man is a shade.
Damn it! It's a trap!
They figured as much.
They've been possessed somehow.
Keep your guard up. Others are sure.
You guys sure are taking your goddamn time.
Thousand apologies. We were distracted by the local welcoming party.
Want some help?
A twisted ring.
A carnival of murder? I love it. Yeah.
Kaine, the villagers are possessed.
But not all of them. Some are still human, so be careful.
Showed up.
Why did you even come here?
By this lady. She's a shade. No. No.
You people are the monsters here.
Stay back, kid. Your sister is one of them now.
I think they're just possessing the body. Like what's currently happening with Kaine? Because Kaine can also turn into a shade. When she loses, like, possession over her body.
Kaine!
And we, who, like, we're only just vessels for these gestalts, the shades. They are supposed to go into us. The problem is that the replicants...
Stop it! Don't hurt my sister!
The problem is the replicants started living and having lives and memories and feelings all on their own, so the shades are no longer compatible.
What madness. These people are behaving as if we are the villains.
Are we the baddies?
them! Kill them now!
No! You've got to stop this! We're trying to save you from the Shades! Please, you have to stop!
Emil!
We need... Get out of here! Kaine, get up! Hurry!
Oh, the little vixen has finally run out of steam. Is it my turn now? Are you sure?
Right.
About that
so what
sunshine?
Happened to Yona at Route 8 is that she had her that was unsporting.
Stop this
she
at
had
once.
Her
leave us in peace.
She had the proper gestalt in her.
Villagers are under attack over there.
But her replicant had wanted her like old life back. So she didn't fit. But there's some shades. Jesus. There's some that, like, probably don't mind.
Oh, that hurt.
Even if they're not the right fit, it's something that's safer.
Kaine, you gotta get up! Emil, watch Kaine. I'll go clean up over there.
All right.
Go away. I can't deal with this.
What could those black swirls be? Is this beast a shade as well? That thing sucked up the villagers.
No! If we keep this up, we're gonna kill them all! We can't let that happen!
Something from within the creature.
Is this the combined power of all those shades?
It will take more than a barrage of magic to stop us. The first to waver is the first to die. I sense magic coming from the center of that eye.
Wait! I think those are actual people!
Hold nothing back. Those are shades! The surrounding tentacles appear to deflect magic. Smaller enemies has no effect on the leader. Focus your magic on the beast's center. Located around the back. Try attacking it from above.
I'll try to pin it down.
Emil!
Emil!
I'll keep it busy. You should be able to attack from behind. Go around and get it. Please, hurry!
Emil can handle this. We must circle behind the creature at once. You must strike it in the eye.
can't do this for much longer.
I hadn't been like jumping off the edge even despite swinging, so I don't know. He suddenly did his. I must have accidentally hit a triangle. And he just started,
Did we get it?
It is escaping to the inner level.
I'm coming. Gotta catch my breath.
Careful, Linda. Won't help anyone if we lose you here. Damn it! We beat the hell out of that thing. How can it still move?
Its combined powers are beyond even my greatest suspicion.
Opinion is Space Jam didn't need a reboot, and it was fine as is. The old one was a classic, and it was cheesy and corny and incredibly dumb in a way that it could only have been at its time. And I don't think trying to replicate that magic is worth doing. Some things are just better as they are. Like, they keep talking about making a Labyrinth reboot. Fuck that. Don't remake the Labyrinth. The Labyrinth is perfect as is. Also, if you wanted to make a sequel to The Labyrinth, you should have done so 30-some years ago when David Bowie wanted to do it. You absolutely idiots. So, I don't think there needs to be a sequel. A remake of Space Jam. Is she less thoughty? That's no good. They didn't even capture the original magic. I wasn't paying attention. I was thinking about Space Jam and David Bowie. Oh no. Two things that don't go together, but don't worry about it. I am technically always thinking about David Bowie. Did they do it because God can't let the... I don't know. The culture today is fucking weird about stuff like that.
Come on! Help me take it out!
I'm on it.
And I don't subscribe to it. Especially when I was growing up, every freaking animator and content creator put all their weird-ass fetishes into my youthful television experience. Let the bunny have big boobs. It's not gonna kill anybody.
He's gone. His instincts have taken hold. The ultimate weapon is being deployed.
Ah, fuck. This ain't good, Sunshine.
I had a chip in my mouth. I was like, oh, cutscene. It's snack time. Little Prince. Uncontrollable magic. I have to protect the people I love. That was my only thought as I unleashed a magic powerful enough to destroy not only the Shade, but everyone else as well. All of them. So many innocent lives. Destroy, eviscerate, crush, kill. These are the dark impulses that override all thoughts. As a being that was created to be a magical weapon, these are my instincts. Or maybe it's better to call them our instincts. A klaxon sounds from deep within the bowels of the laboratory. Thick metal shutters drop down, sealing off the room with a series of dull metal thuds. Abort the experiment! Number 6 is out of control! Everyone get out of here now! Get out of here! The researcher's words are abruptly cut off as a massive hand materializes out of the gloom and lifts him high into the air. The researcher begins to scream. He screams and screams, the sound echoing off the walls of the laboratory and then until the hand squeezes down, putting the room in a deep crimson hue. The rest of his colleagues stand in silence, mouth open, unable to process what they have just seen. Then, a female scientist takes a step back and lets fly with a heartbreaking wail. But this is a terrible mistake, for the sound of her cries only brings forth a monster in all of its terrible glory. Its body is a bloated corpse, its head a grinning skull, and it is a massive, many times the size of a human. The head lolls from side to side as it tromps about the room on all fours, bringing to mind the wild maneuverings of some wretched, starving beast. This creature, this thing, is experimental weapon number 6, also known as Howler. No, oh no, please stop! Oh god, save me, save me! I don't want to die! One by one, the maddened cries of the researchers are silenced. If number 6 understands their petitions, it pays them no heed, instead continuing its rampage of destruction and slaughter with a focus that borders on obsession. After an eternity, the screaming stops, the alarms fall silent, and only then does the creature make a sound, howling out in an unfathomable roar that echoes up and down the empty halls of the blood-soaked laboratory. It's a sound that curses those that have dared bring such evil into the world, and yet one that also seems to be pleading for help. Two sets of footsteps echo in the otherwise silent corridor in the first level of the laboratory. One set belongs to a young boy, his eyes blindfolded and his hands restrained. The other belongs to a severe man in a long white coat. The man draws the boy along by means of a long chain attached to a set of shackles on his wrists. Rubble is scattered here and there across the floor of the corridor, making the journey an exceedingly difficult one for a boy who cannot see. Excuse me? Could you please walk a bit slower? I'm not used to being blindfolded, and Rather than stopping, the man only increases his pace, causing the boy to stumble and attempt to keep up. The last humiliation proves too much, and the boy finds himself unable to arrest his fall. Without the ability to brace himself, he topples to the floor, smashing his head on a pile of debris and causing a trickle of blood to worm its way down his pale, frightened face. Agonized by the pain, the boy inadvertently opens his eyes, calling the falling drops of blood to emit a strange cackling sound before transforming into tiny white rocks. "Close your damn eyes!" roars the man. "Yes, sir," stammers the boy as he slams his lid shut. He hadn't realized the blindfold had slipped off during the fall, but now he keeps his eyes squeezed shut so tightly that sparkles appear against the black of his vision. This boy is Emil, also known as Number 7. He is a magical weapon whose eyes are capable of turning to stone anything that falls under their gaze. "Don't look at me," barks the man. "Never look at me." "I'm sorry, sir. I'm looking at the ground now. So if you just hand me the blind..." Instead of waiting for him to finish, the man extends one foot and presses Emil's face into the floor with a heavy black boot. "Sir, stop. You're hurting me. I told you to keep your eyes and your mouth shut. So do it." The man knows this boy. This weapon could wipe him out with a single glance, and yet subduing him in this way gives him a sense of relief. After making certain the boy is sufficiently cowed, the man leans down, retrieves the blindfold, and knots it tightly around the boy's quivering head. "Right then, on your feet, let's move." Emil staggers to his feet, trying to ignore the red liquid oozing down his face. The blood doesn't matter. The pain doesn't matter. All that matters is finishing the job they had set out for him to do. The second level of the laboratory is in even worse shape than the first. The environs are littered with rubble and rock, making the thought of a decent foothold laughable. When the man's eyes linger on a section of rubble stained deep red, he has a sudden image of warm, gooey brownies slathered in strawberry sauce. His stomach lurches at the thought, but when he attempts to avert his eyes, they land on the remains of a human being rendered into what could only be described as paste. The man blinks. His mind goes strangely blank before attempting to determine exactly how many humans had to be sacrificed to create the scattered piles of flesh around him. After a moment, his thoughts simply cease altogether, as if his mind realizes they are trying to put such a thing into form as folly. "You can go the rest of the way on your own," says the man in a voice much weaker than he wishes it to be. "I mean, what does it matter? You're not even human. You're a monster." With this, the man spins around and dashes back into the hall. A helpless Emil simply listens as the footsteps of his erstwhile captor fade into the distance. Emil finds himself alone in a room with the stench of death and blood. For a moment, he considers opening his eyes, but the thought of the horrors that await him quickly squash this plan. Instead, he stands still and listens intently. Eventually, a far-off sound reaches his ears. "That's the howl I heard before." Emil resumes walking, using the sound of distant voice to guide him, almost as if it was calling him home. By the time Emil reaches the third level, he is moving on memory as much as sound. His hands and face are covered in fresh wounds from numerous falls, but every time he thinks about giving up, his mind returns to his sister. "We studied together. We ate cookies together. We cried together. We laughed together. And sometimes I was the only one who got yelled at. That's why I was never lonely. Our being together allowed me to stay strong. For Emil, his sister was all he had to live for." So holding that feeling close to his chest, he presses on, one slow step after the other. Finally, Emil finds himself drawing close to a certain experimental chamber in the deepest part of the laboratory. The howl is very close now, and as he touches the switch that controls the door, he thinks about his mission. Number 6 is the ultimate weapon. She is his sister, and he must turn her to stone. The door slowly opens, revealing the massive interior of the experimentation chamber. After a few steps, Emil removes his blindfold and slowly opens his eyes. His sister lurks before him, but she looks nothing like the girl he once knew. Instead, he sees a savage beast crawling on all fours through the shredded remains of researchers. As the thing that had been his sister stops and tilts her head in Emil's direction, he focuses his gaze on it. A series of soft, crunching sounds emerge from the creature as his magic does its terrible work. First the fingers, then the hands, arms, legs, head. What little color the beast once possessed fades to a dull, ashen gray. And yet somehow, it summons what strength remains and pulls itself toward Emil, one slow, lumbering effort at a time. Wailing, the massive monstrosity closes in. Is she worried about me? Or is she coming to kill me? Emil feels prepared to accept either outcome. After all, This was his older sister, the person he loved more than anyone else in the world. Halua, I'm... The moment Emil speaks, number 6 comes to a sudden halt. Silence descends on the chamber as the siblings stare at each other. I'm sorry, Halua, but everyone says you're too powerful. They say it's too dangerous unless I seal you away. I'm so sorry. As Emil watches her body begin to turn to stone once more, number 6 simply waits in utter, perfect silence. I'm sorry. The moment number 6's petrification is complete, her memories flood into Emil's mind. The two of them huddling together in the cold. All alone in the world, with no one to protect them. All she wanted was to save her little brother. And yet, it was that little brother who, in a sense, saved her. The moment the petrification is complete, Emil sinks to his knees. A frozen sister and a little brother racked with sin. Alone in this cold cage, the two of them weep in a single, silent voice. It was our combined power that destroyed the Airy. Whole existences, entire lives, even their memories, we took it all. We took everything! My sweet, gentle sister turned into a monster, and the same thing will happen to me now that I have her power. If my instincts as a weapon win out and destroy me in the process, if that power ends up hurting someone I love, I...
We had best be off.
Yeah.
I think it's nice.
Maybe Popol has found some information about the Shadow Lord. Let's drop by the village.
Very well.
I think it's too sunny for the boys that I need to be out here.
Hey, Popola.
Ah, you're back.
Have you learned anything more about the Shadow Lord's key?
I'm sorry, but it's going to take me some time yet.
I see. Well, can I take something off your plate in the meantime?
Oh, how about this? You know the ferryman with the red bag, right? Well, he's been skipping out on work lately. Can I ask you to go to Seafront and check on him?
Sure thing.
Oh, yes. I forgot that was next. I was like, oh, we're gonna get to go to a wedding next, tomorrow. And we still might be able to do that. So that's tomorrow. The Seafront journey.
This feels alarmingly familiar.
Ha! I'm sure that couple is merely having another one of their inane spats. Let us do our utmost not to get dragged into it this time,
All right, so that's going to be it for us today. We will do the seaport stuff and probably Loyal Cerberus tomorrow. And we'll probably finish Route B then on Tuesday. But we'll see. Thank you so much for being here. I will be back tomorrow at 2 p.m. EST with more Transistor. Otherwise, I will be back here with more NieR at 6 p.m. EST. Thank you so very, very much for being here. And I all hope you have a lovely evening. I'm going to eat these chips. I am so hungry. And I won't have to voice anything, and it'll be great. So thank you very much. Take care, and have a safe evening. I will see you tomorrow. Goodbye.